How's it going, everybody? Ben Larry here. Christmas is over, and so it's time to get back to some productivity. And also, I really enjoy the whole thing of goal setting around Christmas time, New Year's. I really like that, because the idea is you're supposed to choose goals that excite you, that you feel some enthusiasm for. And if it feels like a burden or a chore, or you don't really want to do it, you're obviously aiming in the wrong direction. You're aiming for things you think that you think you should do, as opposed to things you actually want. You know, because if you actually want it, then it comes with excitement and enthusiasm, doesn't it? So it's like there's an aiming error there. You see what I mean? Okay, so here's how this started. I noticed that one of the main factors in my mood and state of mind, whatever you want to call it mental health if you want, I'll just call it mood, is things to look forward to, stuff to look forward to, right? And so I noticed if there's stuff in the diary, whether it's social events or whatever it is, or professional events, that makes you feel better, doesn't it? Because there's stuff in the future, okay? So because of that, I started off with a spreadsheet so I could plan events, okay? And it's also good for business and networking and getting customers and that kind of thing, because I do video editing for people. Anyway, now, one of the things that I really wanted to do is to be able to output the number of events I've got as an HTML output. In other words, display it as a web page, and that's what I've achieved recently. So here you can see the number of professional events got coming up. These are all dynamic, right? So if I go to my sheet, okay, let's test this. If I say there's a new event coming up. Now, I recently joined a networking organization called Zocket. Let's say we got a new Zocket in Newport coming up. Let's say, by the way, yeah, let's say I'm definitely going to attend it. And it's called, let's just make one up. Let's say it's called Zocket New Year Day, New Year's Day. And let's say it's on the 1st of Jan 2020. Okay. Start time doesn't matter. Description doesn't matter. Submit. So what happens is that's going to end up on, you should see it appear here. It put it in there and it automatically reorganized the date so that they're in chronological order. So for the 1st of January is a Wednesday. There's Zocket Newport and the name of the event is Zocket New Year's Day. Okay, right. So if you remember, I think there were six. So what happens actually behind the scenes is there's this other sheet, which is got all the organizations. There's Zocket Newport. And if I zoom that out a little bit, it's a business networking event. It's categorized, and it's categorized as a professional event. And what that happens is ultimately the ends. There's a number there, which is how many Zocket Newport events I've got, and that's in the professional event column. And there's now seven instead of six, right? And what that happens is it goes via this code. It gets passed over to some HTML output, and it ultimately ends up displaying, if I refresh it, let me refresh it. Yeah, there's now, where did I go from 5 to 7? I don't know. But anyway, that you can see that number has changed. Now, this gives me effectively, also it's responsive to mobile or desktop. This ultimately gives me a dashboard, right? Of how much stuff I got coming up. And I can very, you know, you can see, I can very quickly see I'd like some more events in my diary, right? Because also, when you think of your state of mind, there's an element of balance, right? Isn't there? If you've just got work events in there and you've got zero for social, well, there's something out of balance about that, isn't there? So this is a very easy way of seeing the balance in your life, okay? Now, if it's all social, if I got 55 social events and zero professional events, well, you know, you can get an idea of how my life is going to play out, can't you? I'm going to have loads of friends and no money. And activities. Now, what I consider that to be is like stuff that I wouldn't usually do that, you know, it's not a social event, not a professional. That might be like an outdoor activity or just something I wouldn't usually do. So there's an element of variety with activity. It's like going places I wouldn't usually go, doing things I wouldn't usually do, doing an activity I wouldn't normally do in the normal course of my day-to-day life. So that's a variety element. Other, I don't know, whatever, other. Okay, so there you go. Now, what's the next thing I'm going to work on? Next thing I'm going to work on is, I'm not sure actually. I'm not sure. Because what I'm finding is I'm learning to program in the process of solving my own problems or yeah, streamlining my own life. Yeah, you know. So that's what I'm doing. All right, that's all I've got to say for now. Bye for now.